greetings. This has become part D in my response to a response about Isaiah 42:12. Let's refresh exactly where we were. It is the God of Jesus who is only one person, John 17:3. So don't try to fool people, stay on topic. Bless your heart. Context matters. Let's look at the context of this verse, that you attempt to rape, brother. John 17:1. Jesus spoke these words, lifted up his eyes to heaven, and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that your Son also may glorify you. This is so rich with truth that damns Muhammad's religion. Jesus lifted up his eyes to heaven to pray. Jesus did not pray with his forehead on the ground like a worthless slave. Father, Jesus called God Father. No one following Mohammedism would ever call God Father. Glorify your Son. Jesus, referencing himself, again calls himself the Son of God, that your Son also may glorify you. Jesus, as the Son, seeks only to glorify his Father. John 13:31. When Judas had gone out, Jesus said, Now the Son of Man is glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify the Son in himself, and will glorify him at once. That means it's going to happen soon. So right off the bat, brother, John 17 damns a defense of Islam. Verse 2, as you have given him, this is Jesus talking about himself, as you have given him authority over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many as you have given him. Jesus has authority, the power to give eternal life to anyone God has directed, guided to Jesus, the Son of Man and Son of God. Again, brother, any attempted use by Islam of this passage is foolish. Now we get to the verse you rape out of context, vainly imagining such will create respect for Mohammedism. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ whom you have sent. We know from verse 1 Jesus respects God his Father. And we know from other scripture Jesus is one with the Father, who is also God. John 10:30, I and my Father are one. John 10:33, the Jews answered him, saying, For a good work we do not stone you, but for blasphemy, and because you, being a man, make yourself God. Jesus' claim to being God was clear enough to kill him for making it. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. Because we respect all that Jesus said, brother, we understand. We Christians understand what Jesus said and meant. But why did Jesus ever refer to Jehovah God the Father as God? First, and primarily because he was an example of perfect human behavior and reverence of God. The fact he, Jesus, was God can easily bake your brain when you ignore all that God has revealed. Philippians 2:5, Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who, being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a bondservant and coming in the likeness of men. Another translation, same verse, says, "But emptied himself, having taken the form of a servant, having been made in the likeness of men." Jesus emptied himself of his deity and took on human form, appearance, likeness. In this empty condition, Jesus called God, God. And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the cross. That is an interesting description. In appearance, he looked like a man. Why not just say, and being a man, just like all men? Give that some thought. I have glorified you on the earth. I have finished the work which you have given me to do. In John 19:30, so when Jesus had received the sour wine, he said, "It is finished." And bowing his head, he gave up his spirit. And now, Father, glorify me together with yourself, with the glory which I had with you before the world was. This is really important, brother. Jesus is asking his Father to glorify him, Jesus, with God. That seems pretentious, especially given Isaiah 42:8, which we've been looking at. I am Jehovah, that is my name. I will not yield, give, share my glory to another, or my praise to idols. It would be a no is the only possible answer for this request. But what Jesus says next is shocking and changes everything. With the glory which I had with you before the world was. God not only shared his glory with Jesus, but shared it with Jesus before the world was, before creation. Jesus existed before creation, and Jesus was aware. He knew. He existed with God, as God, before creation. So why did Jesus call God the one true God? First-hand, intimate knowledge from being one with Jehovah God. I have manifested your name to the men whom you have given me out of the world. They were yours, you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. That is why the name Jehovah is critical and not to be raped for an Arabic word. Now they have known that all things which you have given me are from you. For I have given to them the words which you have given me, and they have received them, and have known surely that I came forth from you, and they have believed that you sent me. Jesus is the promised prophet of Deuteronomy 18. Stay on topic. I think I am on topic, and have taught you the truth, brother. The question is whether you desire truth or worship Muhammad above Jehovah God, your Creator. We'll get to more of your response in the next part of this video series. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.